Yo.
Yo.
Glad you're up, my friend. So, currently outside recording this little segment, because honestly, weather is sort of nice, and you know, I want a little bit of variety with the vlog, but today what I sort of wanted to talk about is why I do what I do, and why you should reconsider why you're doing things, right? And so I urge everyone, by the way, this is like based off this book where it's called Finding Your Why, so I'll leave a picture right here, but basically, this book talks about why people do what they do. I mean, the title is pretty self-explanatory because like it's called Finding Your Why. But what basically I took out of this book is that you need to find your purpose. Your purpose needs to be very well defined and it needs to be very clear. But not only that, you need to understand that your purpose has to be something that is bigger than you. Because if your whole purpose is something very selfish, like I want to make money or you know, I want to buy this fancy car, or I want to buy this house, or I want to buy this watch, then you're just bound to fail. Because if it's just limited to you, if it's just something that is very selfish and it's only benefiting you, then guess what? You can let yourself down. But chances are, you probably wouldn't let someone, if it's someone close to you or someone that you value so much, you wouldn't let them down. And so you need to find a purpose that is bigger than you. It has to be something greater than you, and it has to be selfless. A lot of people tend to be very selfish with their goals, but very selfless with their time. What you have to do is you have to be selfish with your time and resources, but very selfless with your goals and aspirations. And so if your goal is to retire your parents, for example, that is a very selfless goal, but you need to understand why exactly you're trying to retire them. Is it because they've worked very hard for you? Is it because, you know, you had a rough upbringing and you know maybe you couldn't afford a lot of things when you're growing up? Or maybe it's just because you respect your parents so much. You just wanna, you know, ensure that they have a very easy and happy life. Whatever that is, you need to understand it and you need to have it very well defined and very clear. And this is what's going to literally keep you disciplined once you understand what your why is. Once you have that foundation, you're then ready to basically conquer and do anything. Anytime you just happen to get distracted or try and, you know, fall into traps and pits that might not benefit your goal directly, you can instantly check, hey, is this helping me reach my goal? Is this helping me achieve my purpose in life? Or is this going totally against it and is going to mess me up in the path that I'm trying to achieve? So I hope you guys enjoyed this little talk for today. But yeah, just enjoy the rest of the vlog. My SD card is about to run out, so I'm gonna go inside and yeah, so I'm gonna head inside and basically just get straight to work. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, it is currently 4:30 p.m. almost 4:30, and I am currently working on a game plan for a potential client. So basically making a little sort of flow chart explaining sort of low ticket, high ticket offer breakdown, a potential case study funnel, and obviously a bunch of other things. But it's not like fully, like I'm not gonna fully basically make a full game plan because they're still sort of like a potential client. They're not like a current client right now. So if they do end up signing, then I'll give them like the full version and I'll go ahead and finish the full version. But like my philosophy when it comes to attracting new clients and attracting new customers is give as much as possible. I'm trying not to cover up the mic like last time because I got a lot of comments saying, yeah, when you put your right hand on the camera, the mic gets... Anyways, so my philosophy when it comes to attracting new clients is give as much value as possible, and then they'll be like feeling very, very, very entitled to sort of pay you back. And that way, you can basically guarantee that you're getting a very good client who's going to stick with you for a really long time. So that's what I'm currently doing right now with this whole thing. And I'll pick up the camera like after once I'm like fully done. Also, guys, if you are sort of trying to get into meditation or you know, you've been in meditation and you want sort of like a very cool app without having to, you know, pay for all these other apps, I do pay for Brain FM, which is sort of like binaural beats and all that stuff, and it does offer meditation, but I find that it's very, I don't know, it's not as calming as this one. So this app is called Soothing Pod, and I honestly recommend it so much because it's just so good than all the other apps that I've tried before, and it's free. So there's that.